In this video, I'm going to show you how we can build an AI image generator without writing a single line of code. I believe in building AI applications that can assist us with everyday tasks. And the application that we'll build in this video can be very helpful for generating images for articles, blog posts, or YouTube thumbnail ideas. Let's have a quick look at what we'll be building. The idea behind this application is to allow the user to upload the contents of a blog post or an article or whatever else. For example, let's say we wanted to generate a unique header image for this article. We could simply copy all of this text and paste it into the user input. But what we can also do is inform this application to follow a very specific design pattern, like the color schemes and the brand. So if we wanted our image to contain the color schemes used throughout this OpenAI website, we could simply take a snapshot of this website and then select that file using this file node over here. So now, when we execute this application, it will generate a unique image which is based on the content of the article, and it will also include the color schemes from the example image. And after a few seconds, you will receive some image which you can use in your article, or perhaps at least a design concept that you can work with. Now let's have a look at building this from scratch. And the best part, there's no coding involved. For this, we will use a platform called VectorShift. And if you do want to learn this platform in detail, I do have a few other videos as well. VectorShift has a very generous free tier, so you will be able to follow along with this tutorial. And you will not pay a single cent for this. Let's go to login and go ahead and create a new account if you haven't done so already. Then from this pipeline screen, click on new, then click on create pipeline from scratch. So as I've mentioned, I've already created several other videos on VectorShift. So if you do want to learn the fundamentals, I do suggest checking out those videos as well. But in this video, we will focus on learning a few new modules, especially these multimodal nodes over here. Specifically, the image gen node, which will allow us to generate images, and the GPT-4 vision node, which will allow us to upload an example image to get the style information. But if you are new to VectorShift, don't worry, I will keep this tutorial simple and you will be able to follow along. As per usual, let's start by adding an input node and an output node. The input node simply allows the user to send messages to our AI application, and the output node is responsible for returning a response. Up until now, we only had a look at using the text type on the output node, but of course in this demo, we want our application to return an image instead. So we can change the type from text to image. Now, first let's have a look at taking the input from the user and generating an image from that. We can do that by going to multimodal and let's add this image gen node to the canvas. Now let's have a look at this node in detail. First, we need a prompt, and for now, let's simply take the message from the user and pass that over as the prompt. And let's also take the output of this node and pass it to the output node as well. And let's also change the model from Dall-E 2 to Dall-E 3. You might also want to try out the Stable Diffusion XL model, which produces some exceptional results. I'll just go with Dall-E 3 for this demo. We can also change the resolution based on whatever you're trying to generate. I'll just go with this resolution. We can also define the number of images which we want to generate each time. I'll just leave it at 1. We can already test this out by running run pipeline, and then let's enter a description of the image that we want, like a dog running in the field. Let's click on run, and we get this image of a dog running in the field. We can now download this image, and this looks pretty cool. So instead, what we want to do is allow the user to upload the contents of an article, and then two things need to happen. First, we want our application to summarize the article and then pass that summary into this image generation node. But secondly, we also want this image to contain the styles and branding of our website or whatever we're generating the image for. Let's first have a look at summarizing our article. Let's scoot this input node over and let's break this connection. Let's add this OpenAI node. And let's give this a system message. Your job is to summarize a blog article into key bullet points. Of course, if you're creating an image for something else, like a YouTube thumbnail, you might want to change this to something like a video transcript. We can now take the user's message and pass that into the prompt. Let's also change the model to the newer GPT-4o model, and let's pass the response over to the image generator. However, it would not make sense to simply pass this summary to the image generator, as the image generator probably won't produce very good results based on these bullet points. Instead, we want to tell this image generator what its function is. So let's add a prompt to this, like, your job is to generate an image for a blog article. Make sure that the image is relevant to the summary of the article. Also, ensure you generate the image in the brand stone, which will become important in a second. And also, keep the design clean and simple. Now we just need some way of passing the summary into this node. And at the moment, we don't have that as an option. So what we can do is add a new variable. Let's call this summary. And we can add a variable by clicking on these curly braces. And let's give it a name like summary. And you will now notice that we get this new input over here. So let's now take the output from our LLM and pass that into this image generation node. The next step is to also pass in an example image which contains the styles that we want. But before we do that, let's actually run this. And also, if you are enjoying this video, then please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Let's run this, and I'm actually going to copy the text from this article again, and let's paste that into the input. Let's run this, and because this article is focused on using ChatGPT in a medical field, the image that was generated does contain elements of what we were looking for. But now let's also bring in some of the colors and branding from the OpenAI website. So all I did was to take a screenshot of the OpenAI website and I saved this image on my local machine. Now let's have a look at how we can upload that image to our application and then pull all the styling information from it. This is a very good use case for using GPT's vision capabilities. So under Multi-Modal, we can add this GPT-4 vision node to the canvas, like so. This node allows us to upload images to an LLM, and we can then ask the LLM to extract information from it. Let's change the model to the GPT-4o model, and let's also add a system prompt. This is simply, your job is to create a brand guide based on an image. Summarize the brand colors, style, and tone. Now let's have a look at how we can actually select the file. For that, go to Data Uploaders and add the file node to the canvas. Let's uncheck process files into text, and let's pass in our file into the image input. I can now go ahead and upload the screenshot, like so. And all we have to do now is pass the result of this image to text LLM, which will give us the brand color, style, and tone, and pass this into our image generation node. Again, we need to create a new variable to create another input into this node. Let's call this tone, and let's also create a new variable called tone as well. So now we can simply grab the response from this node and pass it into the tone, like so. Great. So let's run this again. Let's copy the text from that article. Let's pass it into the input and let's run this. And this time we do get an image that fits the theme of the article and closely resembles the color scheme and theme from the OpenAI website. If you enjoyed this video and if you would like to learn more about using VectorShift, then check out this playlist over here. And thank you for watching.